वेलकम टू क्लास थ्री ऑफ CM2। विल कंटिन्यू विथ बाइनोमियल ट्रीज। टुडे विल डू रिकम्बाइनिंग बाइनोमियल ट्री। इफ यू चेक हियर, एट टाइम जीरो वी हैव वन स्टेट एंड एट टाइम वन we have two states. If you start with 0, the number of states you can write 2 power 0, that is 1. This is 1, 2 power 1, 2, and this is 2, you can write 2 power 3, 2 power 2, that is 4, and here 3, 2 power 3, that is 8. Okay, we have 8 states. So now we'll do the problems. I mean, you can say these are the particular cases where the mid one that remains the same. Okay, we don't have two here. I mean, two separate here. If you compare with this one here, from this step, I mean, from time one to time two, if you consider the second period, the first period we have up and down. In the second period, the down one here for the second period and the up one here for the second period, they're not matching, they're different. However, if you come here, they're the same. This will happen if they will match, the upward and the downward, they will remain constant from period to period. Okay, then only you will get this way. So we'll see one problem. If you see the number of states reduced by from 2 power 3 to 4 here, okay, if we have 0 here, 1 here, 1 plus 1, the formula is n plus 1 here. So here 1, here 2, if you write 3 here, sorry, 2 here, we have 3. 3 here, we have 4. So you see the number of states decreased, right? The number of states decreased here, 8, 2 power 3. So the formula here is n, you can write an arrow, you can say n plus 1, n plus 1 of n plus 1 number of states when the time is n. However, here 2 power n when the time is n. Now if you take a number 10 here, 2 power 10 number of states, I think it's 1024. How about this n plus 1, 10 plus 1, 11? Okay, so it decreases by a lot. If you come across this example, this is the first one we'll discuss today. Consider a binomial lattice model. This is called lattice model. Okay, for 2 month call option, the period is 1 month here. Remember, there are two periods. So we have two periods here. We are considering a two period binomial tree. We can say it recombining binomial tree, which is a particular case of binomial tree with a lattice with an exercise price of 200. Suppose that the share price either goes up by 4% or down by 3% each month. So if it goes up, it will go up by 4% only, that is constant, that will not change. Unlike the last problem, if you remember the last problem, going up in one period and going up in the other period, the percentages were not the same. But now here, if it goes up, it will go up by 4% only. If it comes down, it will come down by 3%. Okay, so it remains constant. And risk-free continuously compounded rate is given 0.5% per month, and the current share price is 200. Okay, exercise price also 200. Use the formula to estimate the value of the option. For this there is a formula, different formula. We'll use that formula, but before going to the formula, let's write all the values one by one. Symbols, okay, these are the symbols of CM2, UD square. okay, and this will be s naught d power 3. This way you have to tell me s naught is given 200 here, and this is 2 months, we will consider 1 month. 1 month interest rate is given, will not worry, period is 1 month, and u is 4%. 4% means you have to take 1.04, and this is 3%. Okay, 4% means what? U is 1.04, right? And d is, what is d? It's like 1 plus i, 1 minus you have to write, okay? That will be 0.97, 1 minus 0.03. So these are the values. These are the values you know. Because there are only two chances. Either it will go up in each period, period is 1 month here, or it will come down. In addition to that, we say recombining, because these are fixed, okay? If it goes up, it will go by 4%, go up by 4% only, from here to here, another 4%, okay? Then down by 3%. This is down, up, up, down, there 3%. I will write one formula and slowly things will be clear. So VT is the formula. VT is the option price, okay? Don't worry about the formula. I mean the symbols, I'm talking about the symbols. We'll introduce one by one. VT is the option price here. Let me use another ink. VT is the option price here, okay? VT. VT. In the question, they asked to find the option price at zero here. So we'll take T zero anyway. But the formula is in terms of T. You can take T anywhere, okay, 0, 1, whatever you want. The formula is e power minus r n minus t. R is given 0.5%, and n, you have to know what is n. N is 2 here, t 0 here, okay, because we are finding the option price here. Remember, option price here is the premium. Premium is the word we use only at zero. Here we say option price. Here we will say option price. The payoffs will be the option price. Okay. So e power minus r n minus t. Then we have to write summation. K will be from zero to n minus t. This is the general formula. And remember, we use f here. I'll introduce the symbols, okay? Once this chapter is over, in another two classes, we'll go to the derivative chapter. Because the derivative chapter was there in CT1, now that is there in CM2, okay? So we'll do derivatives as well. And then we'll do options. ST, if by chance you don't know properly, you'll get a chance to know the difference also. N minus T minus K, this is symbol. So why I said all this? F means the option price, okay? See, when I write FSN, all the time you see this one in CM2, S we use for stock price, okay? Suppose stock price movement is like this in the market. At time N, SN is the stock price. The underlying is stock. We're talking about financial contracts, okay? Financial contracts, not commodity. So SN is stock price here at time N. F of SN means that is the option price. When I have written this one, see, when I say F of something is the price of the option at time N, okay? SN is the price of the stock. FSN is the price of the option. Why we say F? This is function. We write FX. It's a function of X. When I write X square, when X changes, F of X changes. We write normally Y. So when X changes, Y changes. When SN will change, when N will change, SN will change. When SN will change, FSN will change. What is FSN? FSN is the stock, SN is the stock price. FSN is the option price. Option price will change from time to time. Okay. Suppose option price something is here, we don't know, that is what we find. Option price will change here it will change here, it will change here, here and here, but we will not say this way because we know the stock price now. We are saying this way according to time. In continuous time stochastic process, when we use continuous time stochastic process and we model using continuous time and continuous state, okay, and we will use Black-Scholes formula, we will see at every time, after 5 minutes, after every second also, if you apply the formula, it should change. Okay, now there is a concept of one time period, that is 1 month, but we will go to the general one later, maybe after 5 to 10 classes. Coming back to this one, you just see the formula here. This is the discounted one, okay, whatever periods, n is 2, t is 0, so minus 2 are, so that will be the discounted one, and these are the option prices, okay. Starting from here, we will come back here. So F when we have written, and S naught, suppose you start from T0, what will happen? This will give you up and down, different nodes, okay. Let me write here. We have another term also, I will write that. I mean another expression here, okay. But before that, let me write this part. Because we will find V0, okay, and N is 2 here. Let me write that way. V0 is equal to, you put K0, and then you put, you go up to N minus T. N is 2 here, T is 0, 2 minus 0, that is 2. So there will be three terms here. For K0, one term, then for K1, and for K2. And then using the prices, we will be able to get it, okay. How can I write the next one here? Okay, so one extending here. It will be the binomial coefficient. I can write in using combination also, n minus t factorial divided by k factorial n minus t minus k. T 0 here, we are finding price here, okay, so we'll change it. Then q power k 1 minus q power n minus k minus t is there, n minus t minus k, okay. This is the formula. So we'll write all three terms here. V naught, when you take T0, T0 here and N2, it will be e power minus 2R. It will be e power minus 2R, okay, minus 2R. And let me write everywhere e power minus 2R. Then F of, you put T0 here, S0, that means starting from here, 0. I have taken k 0 here, right? So u power 0, t 0 anyway, this one is 0, this is 2. So, sorry, k is 0, u 0, right? U 0 is 1, k I have taken 0, okay? So, why to write then? So k 0, this is 2, this is 0, this is 0, okay, d square I can write. This is the second one, and this one is, this is anyway 2 factorial, then t 0, k 0, n 2, so again 2 factorial, that is 1 anyway, and then q power 0, 1 minus q power 2 minus 0, so 1 minus q square. This one also I am not writing, 1 minus q square. You will be able to know all the terms one by one. I got already one term, I will show you that term now. See, s naught d square is actually this. This is s naught d, this is s naught d square, okay. So if I say s naught d square, then this is the stock price, okay, 188.18. This is the share price. Now when I say F, this will be the option price. But what is the option price here? Option price means what? What is the price? of that contract, that paper, that legal document that I have, what is that price? So I have two options now. Either I will sell it or I will exercise it. I can't exercise before, right? I can exercise it. So if I don't want to exercise, if I sell it, I should get the same price. Forget about that 2-3 whatever commission the other guy will take. I can sell it to some. I have a paper, I can sell it, right? The selling price is the payoff. Exactly. If you forget about the cost and everything, if someone might demand, okay, to bring that one, that's a separate thing. Otherwise, the payoff is the payoff is the price here. Okay, so payoff is the option price here. Stock price is 188.18. F of this one is the option price here. Okay, so what is the option price here? The payoff. What is the payoff here? You need to know the strike price. What is the strike price here? Let's see, what is the strike price here?
So 200.
200. Yeah, 200 strike price. Okay, they are the same in this problem, right? So 200 here. So what is the payoff here? K is 200. But what is the payoff here? What is payoff here?
11.82.
We are talking about call option, okay? Is it call option? Let me check once again. The problem, this is call option or put option?
Call option.
Call
sir.
Option, okay? We are doing call option only. I didn't go to put option, okay? I thought maybe I brought one put option. So in call option, what is the payoff? That is my question, okay?
Zero.
Yes, zero. Because you will not exercise, right?
Yes.
So see, what I'm saying is, if this is 200, that means the market price is 201.78, okay? And I want to purchase a 200. If I will purchase a 200 from that guy, I will exercise the contract, okay? So I'll have to bear a loss, right? Sorry, here, I will have to bear a loss, right? 188.18, that is the market price, but why I will, I will take it from this guy, exercise, and I will take this share, which is worth 188.18 in the market. So it's better, I will not exercise it. So my payoff will be zero. How about this? S naught, it should be UD, okay? Here, I will do it and I will get this amount, okay? This amount I can make a profit. Here also I will exercise. I will get this S naught U square. This is the notation, okay? Payoff notation. That is the price of the option here. This is price of the option, okay? Notation, you remember. And this value will be 16.32. Now, I need to know here and here, okay? For that, I can go backwards from here to here, discounted value, and I can go come from here to here, here to here, here to here, then here to here. What we do is, in normal binomial trees, we go back all the steps, but here it will be a bit easier because these two, they match, I mean their values match. Let me write the second term here, plus. And plus third term. Let me write the third term here. E minus, this one means, what is the discounted value? This is what we found. Let me show you this way. This is what we found, right? This one. This value is this one, okay? And this value, this is the option price, you can say, okay? So with what probability my payoff will be zero? With this probability, 1 minus Q, 1 minus Q. With this probability, my payoff will be this, okay? So if you find the present value here, okay? So if you find the discounted value here, with the probability you have to multiply 1 minus q square, you have to discount it, e power minus 2r, r is 1 period, here 1 period is 1 month, that's a separate thing, e power minus 2r, you have to write 0.5% here, you will get the value. So the value at time 0 in respect of this node is this one, we got 1, okay. Similarly, we'll find this one. So what is the value of f s naught d square? This is 0. So this will not contribute. How about this one? F s naught d square here. If I write the third term, s naught d square, sorry, u square, this value is actually 16.32. Okay, this value is 16.32. This is 16.32, and this we know, and this also we know, q square. Okay, so if you know q, you know q square. If you know 1 minus q, you know 1 minus q square, and you got two terms. Now you should try the second one. In the second one also we have e power minus 2r, because two periods we have, right? Two periods, this is one period, this is one period. This way it's possible, this way, that's why you will get 2ab. See, if you apply the formula here, you will get, you write here k1. Okay, for k2 it's already over, k0 over, right? Then we'll write k2. K2 is over k1. If you write k1 here, u1 d1, s naught ud, right? F s naught ud. This value is the payoff here, that already we got 1.76, that one we'll write, and we'll discount it twice, we'll go, but we can go this way, we can go this way also, right? So that you will get from the binomial coefficient. Okay, so this is, you can say, 1 minus q q, and this is q, this is 1 minus q. Already I have written 1 minus q. Okay, so that you will get, that coefficient you will get from here, instead of writing twice. This is actually 2 factorial divided by 0 factorial, and if you write k1 here, this will be 1 factorial. Okay, 2 factorial by 0 factorial, 1 factorial, you will get a 2 here extra, but here you will get 1, here also you will get 1. You can check it, this binomial coefficient will be 1 here, because you have only one path, one straight path. Okay, here also it's one straight path, but here it will be 2, because you have 2 path and both are equal. If you don't want to use this one directly, okay, if a problem is given, you find the discounted value twice, it's like 2ab 2ba, sorry, ab ba, if you add, it will be 2ab, that way. Okay, and the value is 1.76, this value, and this q power and all that you have to write. This will be q power 1 and 1 minus q power 1, q 1 minus q. The 2 is there, 2 q 1 minus q. This is q 1 minus q, this is q 1 minus q. Okay, you have to discount. If you do all this, you will get the answer. Okay, so using the numbers we can write. If you know q, then you will be able to find the answer now. If you know q, do you know q? That is the question. What is q here? Who can answer? What is q here? See here, consider a binomial lattice model for a 2-month call option. Exercise price, we have already used 200. Suppose sale price either goes up by 4%, down by 3%, risk free continuously compounded 0.5%, and current sale price is 2%. What is q here? We use a formula for q, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what is that formula?
R minus t by u minus t.
Yeah, that way you have to q. You have to find q. Find q and tell me.
1 minute, sir.
And you tell me q square, q multiplied by 1 minus q, then 1 minus q square.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So let me write, V naught will be equal to all the three terms, let me write, and then the only thing you need to say me is 16.32 then you multiply by q square plus 2 will not come here, 2, this is 1.76 q 1 minus q plus, this is 0 anyway, will not worry, 0 1 minus q square, okay. If you know q, then you know 1 minus q also. E power minus 2r, minus 2 half percent, 0.005. Okay, so this also you have to write. Then 16.32. Yes, what is q?
Zero point five, sir.
Okay, 0.5. Then what is q square?
0.25.
Okay, so that way you complete this and tell me the final value.
Four point nine one.
Okay. So this is the option price.